there they were. There were oyster reefs up the James River, up the York, up the Rappahannock, up the Patuxent, up the Potomac, from the tip of the eastern shore all the way to the Sassafras River. And we thought they would last forever.
Can an oyster commons, open to all, long endure? For over a decade now, Ken Paynter and his divers have been monitoring the oyster grounds of the northern Chesapeake.
Go down, look for oysters, figure out where they are, come back up and we'll talk about how to sample them, okay? All right, go for it.
To me, it was pretty much a no-brainer to use divers to go down.
Check in with your comm gear, please, over.
To observe the conditions on the bottom, or actually inspect these reefs, you know, oyster by oyster. We want to be able to count oysters, so we collect oysters and oyster shell in quadrats so we can get a measure of how many are there.
That's why we're engaged in the research. I think it's important to answer the questions, and I think it's important to ask very hard questions and very critical questions about the reef habitat.
In most rivers, they found low-lying mounds of shells spread out by decades of dredging and tonguing. Only a few live oysters were left. The population count on the world's greatest oyster grounds? One living oyster per square meter.
We have been in other places, places where the salinities are lower, where we come upon beautiful, lumpy, gorgeous oysters.
Wow, that's really good.
And when the camera settled down on the bottom, boom, it was a real revelation.
There's a complex ecosystem that's being developed by these oyster bars. We see these fouling organisms begin to accumulate on the oysters. We begin to see small fish, resident fish, like the gobies and the blennies. And then smaller blue crabs come in. And then larger fish come in and inhabit the larger nooks and crannies that are created as the oysters grow.
That's really cool.
But the visibility's not that bad.
And finally, we've even seen these large striped bass cruising over the oyster bars, looking probably for those small fish.
So we see the beginnings of that good restoration to the places where the salinities are lower. Reef restoration work that we've done so far has demonstrated that reef restoration can work, that when you do restore an oyster reef, we can get good ecological things to happen.